Good afternoon to all of you. Today we are here to discuss British poetry from Chaucer to the 18th century. I am Dr. Amit Kumar Singh from the School of Humanities, Uttar Pradesh Rajarshi Tandon Open University, Prayagraj. The chapter we are going to discuss is mentioned in your course MAEN 101 New. Block 2nd, A Study of Spenser, Shakespeare and Milton, and Unit is 7th, Shakespeare's Sonnet. Our main focus will be on Shakespeare's sonnets. Before that, we will discuss in brief Elizabethan age, Shakespeare's life and works, and then we will come to the sonnet, and we will see its different kinds as Petrarchan sonnet, Shakespearean sonnet, and Spenserian sonnets. Shakespeare was Elizabethan poet, dramatist. Now, Elizabethan period was an era of mixed tendencies. The age of Queen Victoria saw the important changes in the society, in the wealth of England, wasting an empire, and many more things. Often known as Golden Age in English history dates back from 1558 to 1603. At this time, Queen Elizabeth I was reigning England. The England was prospering by leaps and bounds. Elizabethan age was characterized by relative peace and prosperity, by a flowering of artistic, literary, and intellectual culture to a such extent that it is sometimes called as the English Renaissance. In this period, literature and many more diverse tendencies of literature flourished in such a way that it was often called as a renaissance of literature. It means the reign of Queen Elizabeth provided many writers, poets, dramatists, prose writers, their needed goals for creating their specific writings and their verses. Elizabeth herself had a reputation as a lover of the arts, especially music and the theatre, and the patronage from her and members of her court was the foundation of many of the English writers' careers. In Elizabethan age and the age of Queen Elizabeth was also marked by the tendencies that were necessary for the culmination of literary output. Elizabeth herself was a great lover of artistic creation, lover of art, literature, and many more things. Especially in her time, literature flourished so voraciously because he encouraged many writers to flourish during her period. The most famous of these writers were, of course, playwright and poet William Shakespeare, one of the most important writer dramatist of the period was William Shakespeare. Other writers who rose to prominence under Elizabeth include Sir Philip Sidney, Christopher Marlowe, Roger Ascham, Richard Hooker, John Lely, and Edmund Spenser. The period saw the flowering of poetry. The different forms of poetry were flourishing during this period. That were sonnets, Spenserian stanza, dramatic blank verse. It was also a golden age of drama and inspired a wide variety of splendid prose from historical chronicles, versions of the Holy Scriptures, pamphlet, and literary criticism to the first English novel, which is supposed to be published, Robinson Crusoe, published in 1719. Overall, the period was a golden age for literary output. And this was the period when we saw first novel coming out.
in 1719. It was named Robinson Crusoe by Daniel Defoe. Shakespeare's life. Now come to the point. Coming to the point, we will first see how a writer made himself, how a writer created himself. What was the surroundings behind him that created such a genius mind, a masterpiece? Let us see. Shakespeare was baptized in the parish church at Stratford-upon-Avon or Stratford-upon-Avon on April 26, 1564. He may have born on April 23, 1564, St. George's Day, which happens also to be the date of his death on April 23, 1616. Recorded history by historians says that Shakespeare was born at 23rd April 1564. In old England, it was customary to baptize the child after the 3 days of his birth. So, 23rd is the exact day for Shakespeare's birth because historians often recognize the date 26. It means that he was baptized in the third day of parish church after his birth, 26 April. His father, John Shakespeare, was a burgess, an inhabitant of a town and a member of parliament in England. He followed several trades. His father, John Shakespeare, was a member of parliament and he followed several trades for earning his bread and butter. His mother was Mary Arden. She was a housewife, and Shakespeare was the eldest surviving son of 8 children. Shakespeare was probably educated at the King's New School in Stratford, also called Grammar School, where he learnt small Latin and less Greek, which was asserted by his contemporary Ben Jonson. Ben Jonson, of course, said about him that Shakespeare learnt small Latin and less Greek in grammar school of Stratford. After that, there is no record founded for his educational background, where he studied, where he learnt the nature, where he learnt the nature of men, women, where he learnt about society is unknown to us for this time too. In 1582, he married Anne Hathaway. She was 8 years elder to him, senior to him. The marriage was not fruitful. Historians assume so, but the official record is not founded about this statement. In 1584, Shakespeare left his native town to settle in London. In 1584, he left his hometown, Stratford, to settle in London. No exact reason behind this incident were founded in recorded history by the historians, why he left his town. But a certain incident is that he posed in the Park of St. Thomas Lucy, and to be safe against the consequences, he drove out the city. From 1584 to 1592, he was banished from the scene. He appears as a rising actor of drama company in 1592. In 1595, his name appeared with Lord Chamberlain's company of actors. He worked with Sardi Theatre until 1598, and after that with Globe Theatre. And finally, after 1608, with Blackfriars. About 1610, he left London to settle down in Stratford, where he stayed at New Palace, second largest house in the town. 1584 to 1592, he was vanished from the scene. There is no record where he was, what he was doing. But certain historians assumes that he was working with several people in several jobs. In 1592, he appears with the company of Lord Chamberlain's actors. He was acting. After that, he worked with Sardis Theatre and 1598, and after that with Globe Theatre, and finally with Blackfriars. At last, after that, he gave up acting and gave the world his masterpieces, his dramas, his plays, his sonnets. Last days of his life were spent at the new place, the second largest house in the town, which he bought in 1598. Now, let us see what is sonnet. Sonnet, as you know, is a 14-line poem. 14-line poem of single stanza. The lines used are generally iambic pentameter lines, which follow an intricate rhyme scheme. The Italian or Petrarchan sonnet, named after 14th century Italian poet Petrarch, generally falls into two parts. Sonnet is a 14-line poem, and it is made up of with iambic pentameter lines. Petrarchans, there are different variations of the sonnet. First type of sonnet is Petrarchan sonnet, which is named after 14th century Italian poet Petrarch. He invented this form, Petrarchan sonnet. Petrarchan sonnet is divided into two parts, octave and the sestet. First 8 line of the sonnet is called octave, and the second 6 lines are called sestet. Rhyming scheme of the Petrarchan sonnet is CDE CDE or CDC CDC, second 6 lines, and first 8 line rhyming scheme is AB BA AB BA. This is the rhyming scheme of the Petrarchan sonnet, which runs throughout his sonnet. Now comes Shakespearean sonnet or English sonnet. English sonnet is also called Shakespearean sonnet because of his greatness. He was perfect master of sonnet. He has derived many themes in his sonnet, like love, jealousy, hatred, and many more. Actually, he has fathomed the depth of sounded heart and soul of humans through his sonnets. It is the key that with this Shakespeare has unlocked his heart. English are the Shakespearean sonnet. The Earl of Surrey was the inventor of this model. Now, the Earl of Surrey was the inventor of this kind model. This kind. Later, it was named after Shakespeare, being its greatest practitioner. This type of sonnet is divided into 3 quatrains. Shakespearean sonnet is divided into 3 quatrains, and every quatrain is made up of 4 lines. Hence, 4 into 3, 12 lines, and a concluding couplet. There is a concluding couplet at the last of the sonnet, which is of 2 lines. 12 plus 2 lines is equal to 14 lines. Hence, it is 14 lines sonnet. Rhyming scheme for the Shakespearean sonnet is ABBA, ABAB, BCBC, CDCD, EE. And Shakespearean sonnet follow the rhyming scheme of ABAB, CDCD, EFEF, and the couplet GG. So, Shakespeare divided the sonnet into a new model. He divided it into 3 parts. 4 lines each containing 3 parts is called quatrain and a concluding couplet. While as Petrarchan sonnet was mainly divided into 2 parts, octave and sestet. First 8 lines and sestet is the 6 second lines. Next, now we will see examples how the rhyming scheme works. What is rhyming scheme in a sonnet? Here you can see, this is a sonnet from Petrarch, where Petrarch confess his folly. It is a sonnet by Petrarch. Now you can see in the lines, oh yeah, that here in vagrant rhymes the singing. Here note the words, sighing. It is rhyming scheme. Follow the rhyming scheme. A, feeding. B, now the A will match the fourth line. A, B, B, A. This is the rhyming scheme of Petrarchan sonnet. Sighing. So, look at once again. Rhyming words made the rhyming scheme. Sighing, feeding, leading, flying. Sighing with flying, feeding with leading. This made A, B, B, A. Now, next four lines. Lying, reading, bleeding. Reading, bleeding. Lying, crying. A, B, B, A. Next six lines. Derided, chatter, C, D. Chided, derided, C, C. Chatter, scatter, D, D. Glided, matter, C, D. This is the rhyming scheme which was followed by the Petrarch. And you can see why this rhyming scheme is A, B, B, A, A, B, B, A. Next six lines, C, D, C, D, C, D. Because the last word of the line is producing a sound that is rhyming with each other. Derided with chided, chatter with satyr, and glided with matter. Hence, it construct the rhyming scheme of a sonnet. Now, we will look at Shakespearean sonnet. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? It is a sonnet written by Shakespeare, composed by Shakespeare. And rhyming scheme in this sonnet is simple. Day, May, temperate, date, shine. Now look at the examples from Shakespearean sonnet. It is shall I compare thee to a summer's day, composed by Shakespeare. Now here you can see the last word of the line, first line, day, which is rhyming with May, temperate with date, signs with declines, dimmed with untrimmed, fade with said, ovest with growest, see with thee. These last two lines, see, thee, are called couplet. Couplet is made up of two lines. First four lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, construct a quatrain. Quatrain is made up of four lines. Hence, 1, 2, 3, 4. One quatrain, 1, 2, 3, 4. Second quatrain, 1, 2, 3, 4. Third quatrain, G, G. Last two lines is called couplet. Four lines quatrain into three parts. 4 into 3, 12 lines. And when we will add a couplet of two lines, it will be completed by 14 lines, which is called your sonnet. This is what we have discussed in this lecture, the sonnets of Shakespeare. Shakespeare gave a unique deviation from the accepted Petrarchan sonnet form. He divided it into three parts and add a concluding couplet. Shakespeare has written 154 sonnets. 126 sonnets are devoted to his bosom friend W.H., whose identity is also a matter of conjecture, because some historians assumes that he was Henry Wriothesley, but some says that it was William Herbert. and 28 sonnet are devoted to a dark lady. Now this dark lady is also a matter of conjecture, guess, because historians are not certain who this dark lady was. Some says it was Mary Fitton, and some says it was lover of Shakespeare who betrayed him and drove out secretly with his friend. Shakespeare gave his diverse personality traits into his sonnets. He unfathomed the soul of human heart. He wrote the tragedies of human soul. Some critics say that no one in English literature has fathomed so nicely the depth of human soul as Shakespeare has done. So, this is our today's lecture, and we will meet surely with a new lecture in our next. Thank you for all, and thanks for watching me and hearing me patiently. Once again, I am Dr. Amit Kumar Singh from UPRT, Prayagraj. Thank you so much.